Louisiana Legislative Black Caucus and Louisiana Legislative Black Caucus Foundation. The Black Caucus is made up of 32 members from around the state of Louisiana, elected from various districts, African-American legislators. And our foundation is made up of businessmen who come on board to fundraise under our nonprofit arm so we could provide scholarships. We provide individual scholarships throughout our districts. We also provide scholarships and endowed professorships to Southern and Grambling University and other universities as our funds are available. And so it's basically the fundraising mechanism to strengthen education and to give students who are from our district an extra lift when they decide to go to college. And a wonderful thing about our $500 scholarships, we give 32 out a year to represent each member in their district. That can go to someone in elementary, junior high, or high school, or college. And sometimes our members have matched the $500 that we send into their district. They buy school uniforms with it, books, or some donate to libraries at their local schools to make sure they have the books they need for that year for students to check out. So it's just been a wonderful experience. We're actually on our 30th anniversary. So this thing started well before I ever thought of it, okay? And we're celebrating our members this year, our past members. We have some of our founding members here, which is very exciting. Dana Bajwa will be on the podium with us. She's been so supportive over the years, but she is a founding member. Many people don't realize that. She served a long tenure in the legislature, but she's still very strong, and she's an activist in her community. And so it's been a wonderful experience. We have this every year, and it's not really about us. Everything we raise, it goes back into the community throughout the year. This year, we are starting a $10,000 endowment for Southern University and Grambling State University. And your support of the Black Caucus over the years has made that possible. And so we want to thank you for that. We want to thank you for helping us continue to support our HBCUs and our children around the state as we issue scholarships every year. We want to thank you for your commitment and your continued support. We are truly breaking the cycle of poverty through education. And I also want to thank all of you ahead of time for supporting my senator, Senator Mary Landrieu. That's my commercial plug.
I would like to welcome each of you and thank you so much for your continued support throughout the years. This marks our 30th year anniversary of actually having a Bayou Classic brunch. Let's give ourselves a hand of applause for that. 30 years. So again, I would like to thank each of you for your continued support in helping us to make this event a success, not just for the schools that we both celebrate and appreciate, but for the students that receive the scholarships because of the money that is raised from this event.
Thank all of you for taking time out of your very busy and hectic schedule to be here, because ultimately it is about our students. It is about those individuals that we are willing to invest in to ensure the continuity and the legacy of these two outstanding institutions, the children of this great state. Again, welcome and thank all of you for being here.
Now, I'm Patrick Bell. I'm the chairman of the Louisiana Legislative Black Caucus Foundation. And the foundation provides support to the Legislative Black Caucus. And as a result of providing that support, we try to assist the citizens of the state of Louisiana, particularly the African American and the poor and those that are disadvantaged in our state. And the foundation provides that support to the caucus, and we work in concert with that. But one of the reasons I want to tell that story about vision is because vision is defined as seeing things not as they are, but as they can be. And in this coming year, the foundation is looking at doing some exciting things. We spent the last few years working on some internal things, and now we're working on some things next year. And we're going to be counting on you to assist us with these efforts that we're going to do. And so first of all, I want to thank you for your support for the previous years. Thank you for your support today, and we look forward to your continued support next year. But there's some other things we're going to need your help with, and we're hoping that you will join us in continuing our work so that we can continue to be that support mechanism for the Legislative Black Caucus, because they have a very difficult job to do. And without the support of the foundation and without the support of all of you, they would not be able to do their jobs. And so we want to thank you once again, and we look forward to your continued support next year.
We're here today to celebrate the schools, to celebrate the students. But we all know that Thanksgiving ushers in the holiday season and all the joy that it brings, all the glory of life, the holidays, and the promise of a new year. It brings us together. It reminds us of all we hold dear. And if we believe that Louisiana is special, if we want to do our part, then vote. New Orleans is special. Baton Rouge, Lafayette, Opelousas, Shreveport, Pointe Coupee, Monroe, Grambling, Ruston. Louisiana is special. And we want the world to know that, that what we do here matters. Vote. Enjoy the day. Enjoy the game. Enjoy our city.
Good morning.
On behalf of the students, alumni, faculty, and staff, thank you for the opportunity to speak about Grambling State University. I want to especially thank the Legislative Black Caucus and Grambling's representatives, Senator Rick Gallo and Representative Patrick Jefferson, and also my new friends, Senator Tarver, Representatives Jackson, Price, Burrell, Norton, and James. We are grateful for the $1 million in STEM funding this year, and we're using those funds to support scholarships to attract and retain students to Grambling. We also want to thank the legislature for your support for the WISE Fund, for universities to receive their distribution of the $40 million pot of money. A 20% match was required, and I'm here to tell you that we exceeded our match and raised over $300,000. Workforce development is really important for universities, and our partnerships with the private sector will make our students and our programs more successful. And so I want to thank all of the sponsors out there for supporting Grambling State University and Southern and the legislature for providing this support and the new scholarship endowment that they're developing for our students. Our HBCUs need your help. Grambling State University needs your help. Please keep Grambling State University, our initiatives, and most importantly, our students in mind this legislature session.
Out of respect for the new team at Grambling, who I've met and I have a great deal of respect for, and they have a lot of hard work to do there, I want to talk instead this morning about work and love. There is a writer called Khalil Gibran who wrote a little book called The Poet, The Prophet. And in that book, he says that work is love made visible. And I've never forgotten that line. And you know, every legislative session, the Black Caucus works very hard for these two institutions, Southern and Grambling, because there's a lot of hard work to do. It's a battle every year, and but for the Black Caucus, we could not make it from year to year in this environment of budget cuts and downsizing and reorganizations and really attacks on HBCUs. So let's give a hand to the Black Caucus for the work that they do with us. And we all work together because we love the students that we serve, who are very special students in the state of Louisiana, and we take them where they are and give them what they need to be successful in life. And if we didn't work together out of love, we could not get it done.
Thank you for the legislative, Louisiana Legislative Black Caucus. I want to thank you for doing what a lot of other people don't do, which is taking care of the scholarships for our kids. Because I can tell you, I'm from North Louisiana, where a lot of y'all are from, and I went to Tulane, and I couldn't go were it not for a scholarship. And a lot of folks are in that position where the money for the scholarship, however small, will make a difference in their lives, and I'm living proof of that. I want to thank our senator, Mary Landrieu for having done a good job, for Cedric Richmond for having done a good job, for our state. Our state is about us as Louisianians. And Senator Landrieu, I got a little heat, and I think you did too, but you could talk to me. In fact, I sang Can't Help Falling in Love with You at the Washington Mardi Gras and got in a little trouble for it, but I don't care, because we are about North and South Louisiana, and I'll say that Mary Landrieu had enough sense to marry a redneck from Monroe. Mr. Snellings, thank you.
Grambling State University and Southern University both have amazing records of producing football greats that have gone on to become larger-than-life legends in the NFL. I have the privilege of presenting this award, the Bayou Classic Legend Award, to Mr. Everson Walls. Mr. Everson Walls was a Grambling State University SWAC NFL standout. Former defensive back in the NFL, having played for the Dallas Cowboys, the New York Giants, the Cleveland Browns, he was a four-time Pro Bowler. He earned numerous awards, Division I, AA, First Team All-American, Grambling State University Athletic Hall of Fame Award, the SWAC Hall of Fame, and the Tom Landry Award. And which a special aspect of this gentleman that I thought was very amazing for me and had special meaning to me is that he, in 2009, wrote a book, A Gift for Ron, after donating a kidney to a former teammate, Ron Springs, former alumni, and a friend. Ladies and gentlemen, for these great accomplishments and in great acts of giving, I present to you Mr. Everson Walls.
But I really want to thank the Legislative Black Caucus for all the work that they're doing with the HBCUs. One thing I can say, before I went to Grambling State University, you never would see me sitting up here talking to anyone doing any public speaking. I will say that the way my parents raised me, they raised me to do the right thing. And just like any kid, I was as hard-headed as anyone else in this room, and I rebelled. It was when I came to Grambling State University that Coach Eddie Robinson reiterated what my parents taught me at home. And it was because of that that I was able to go on and do some things that I never thought I'd be able to do in my life. Besides football, besides being a father, besides being a husband, being an organ donor, if it wasn't for Grambling State University reiterating what my parents taught me at home, I would not be able to do the things that I've done in my lifetime. I just want to thank y'all so much. I want to thank Grambling State University for always supporting me in everything that I've done. And I, as much as I hate to say it, Southern, my daughter went to your school, so I have to support you as well. And I support all HBCUs, because especially the SWAC. And it's like we always say, if it's all SWAC, it's all black. Thank you very much, and go Grambling.
Ladies and gentlemen, today I have the honor and privilege of introducing a son of New Orleans, a Southern University legend, and one of the best cornerbacks in the history of the NFL. I have the opportunity to introduce a man who is a member of two of the greatest organizations on this earth. One, Kappa Alpha Psi Fraternity Incorporated, and two, the National Football Hall of Fame. In 1989, Aeneas Williams, a graduate of Forche High School, was a junior and walked on to the Southern University football team. That walk-on became a Bayou Classic MVP. That walk-on had a 14-year NFL career that included a Super Bowl victory, 8 Pro Bowls, 4 All-Pro selections. Aeneas Williams walked on and he ran to greatness. Aeneas realized that unhappiness doesn't come from things in our lives, yet it comes from things missing from our lives. And on August 2nd, 2014, Aeneas was inducted into the National Football Hall of Fame. And if any of you witnessed his speech, he mentioned Southern University so many times. Today, Aeneas shares his Reaching Your Potential message to all. He is the founding pastor of Spirit of the Lord Family Church in St. Louis. And he's been quoted as saying, "Wisdom is only practical if you can apply it to your everyday life." Ladies and gentlemen, join me in welcoming a son of New Orleans, a Southern University legend, a Kappa man, a Hall of Famer, and most importantly, a devoted husband, father, and a pastor, Aeneas Williams.
Thank you. Thank you. Well, I'll be brief. It's nothing like being home first. I would like to thank the Legislative Black Caucus and the Black Caucus Foundation, the distinguished guests on the dais with me, all of Southern as well as Grambling alumni and current students and the entire system. It's a great honor for Tracy and I. We are Southern alum. My father graduated from Southern. My in-laws graduated from Southern. But I just want to share something briefly with you guys and how unique it is to be here receiving this award with all of what I call the legislative leaders. My church, my wife Tracy and I pastor the Spirit Church. It is in Ferguson, Missouri. So as I sit here and I listen to our leaders, civic leaders, and to know that everyone in this room are playing the role of changes, and tell you briefly about Southern University and my experience. I had to take remedial classes, starting at Southern University. As was said, I walked on a week before the season started my junior year in college. It was shortly after I had given my life to Jesus Christ. And the reason why that's significant, because growing up, they sent us to church, but it never made sense to me. So I said, "God, if you're real, show me how you relate to us in everyday life." I have one mission in life, and that is to help people go to the grave empty, because most go full. The goal is to go exhausting your potential. Here, I was a freshman and a sophomore, and I had the ability to be one of the best cornerbacks to ever play in the National Football League, and I wasn't playing football. Now, they told me to be brief, but I have to say this before I go, because I don't know what young person is attempting to get a degree. I have a degree in accounting, and I don't even like numbers. But I found out, after giving my life to Christ, the nature of purpose. And I realized the significance of every purpose, of every person. Everything in here has a purpose. Once I realized from traveling on the road with Coach Eddie Robinson, I heard him speak and I became fascinated and I realized that I had the gift to communicate. So after I listened to Coach Eddie Robinson, I got inspired to not only want to speak, but do it for a living. And now I hire accountants. But I want to say to the Southern University, and with all due respect to Grambling State University, that all of us here build the legacy of my parents at these great institutions. But I want you to know, the sky is blue, so I figure it's God's favorite color. So Grambling, we already know who God's cheering for. God bless you guys.
It's always a pleasure to recognize someone you know, someone you've worked with and had an experience with as a community leader in my district. And I thank Representative Barrow for actually putting her name forward. So our next honoree is the epitome of everything this award entails. Ms. Sadie Roberts Joseph has been a lifelong fighter of indifference, intolerance, and injustice. Ms. Roberts Joseph's accomplishments are consistent with the namesake of the Avery C. Alexander Award, as her vision and leadership addresses one of the humanity's greatest challenges, civil rights.
And my predecessor, Reverend Avery C. Alexander, of course, needs no introduction, and Ms. Roberts Joseph has been a pioneer, like him, in the community for over 40 years and has provided services to all equally, impartially, and supportively. Ms. Roberts Joseph was the founder of the Odell S. Williams Now and Then Museum in South Baton Rouge, created to promote and educate people about the historic Juneteenth event and the achievements of African Americans. In addition, Ms. Roberts Joseph has received a plethora of other awards, including the Silver Magnolia Award by the Women's Council of Greater Baton Rouge and the Apple Award by the Volunteers in Public Schools. Ms. Roberts Joseph also serves on numerous boards and organizations advocating for civil rights, and I'm looking forward to all the additional work she's been going to be doing in the next 7 days to make sure she leads those marches to the polls next Saturday.
Sadie, as I warmly call her, continues to be a voice in the community by organizing events like the Friendship March that commemorated Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. and Juneteenth in Baton Rouge. Ms. Sadie Roberts Joseph also continues to encourage, inspire, and educate the African American community to embrace its beauty, intelligence, and diversity. Welcome Ms. Sadie Roberts Joseph as our honoree for the Avery C. Alexander Award.
Thank you so much to this Louisiana Black Caucus and to all of you. On behalf of the African American History Museum, it is our duty and responsibility and our mission to teach, educate, and inspire the next generation of leaders. We firmly believe that culture is the glue that holds a people together. Take a step back in time and leap into your future. We will continue to educate, we will continue to teach, and prepare the next generation of leaders for Southern University and Grambling as well. Thank you. God bless you.
This year, our Pinky Carolyn Wilkerson Award goes to an individual that lives to serve and help others. An individual that I am proud to say I met as a young man, a little boy, as he was instrumental, along with Coach Rob, in getting the New York Yankees to come to Grambling, Louisiana. This year's recipient is the ever so deserving Coach Wilbert Ellis. Coach Ellis is a man that gets people to see themselves more clearly, listens, challenges, shows compassion, guides, and supports individuals. Coach Ellis has also actively engaged in promoting human welfare and social reforms.
I too am glad this morning to be presenting this award. Someone who I've known personally for many years at Grambling. Coach Ellis has been linked to Grambling University since his college and baseball days there. Coach Ellis eventually excelled to become head coach and lead the Tigers to many accomplishments. Coach Ellis became the fourth all-time winningest coach in Louisiana and was awarded the SWAC Coach of the Year 7 times. Coach Ellis also helped 8 individuals to rise to become All-Americans and sent several individuals on to sign with major league teams.
If in our history we have Stalin, Roosevelt, and Churchill, at Grambling State University, there was Coach Rob, Hobde, and Coach Wilbur Ellis.
Coach Ellis is a role model for how all of us should continue to find a way to contribute in a greater way to the community. Coach Ellis continues to remind us to respect and embrace human diversity and improve the lives of those in need through selfless, courageous, and compassionate act. And as I always called him, I present to you my dean when I was in college, Dean Ellis.
Well, it's game time. I want to say on behalf of Grambling State University Lincoln in Union Parish. We just hit something big in Union Parish and Lincoln Parish, November the 4th. We elected the first district attorney, Afro-American, John Belton. And I was happy to be a part of that, as Honorable Patrick Jefferson and also Senator Gallo was very involved. To the Black Caucus, it is just so great what you are doing. But I want to make a statement to all of us, and I want the state of Louisiana to hear this, because it's so important for us to wake up, stand up, and make some tough decisions, but some good decisions. Time is running out. Education is so important for all Americans, Black, white, Gentiles, and all. We must come together to make some good decisions and know our leadership and the importance of leadership. I had something else to say, but Eddie Robinson would say that you must stand and tell the people the truth, because we are asleep. We are asleep. We got Senator Mary Landrum, who's been good to Grambling, to the state of Louisiana, and we need to stand up. Mayor Mayo, who has been good to Monroe and to Grambling and to the state of Louisiana, we need to wake up, stand up. Pinkett Wilkerson, as I received this award today, Pinkett was a role model. Pinkett was a drum major. Pinkett did what she had to do for the people that she represented. And now I'm here to receive this award on this day. That is a great honor. Just a few days ago, I received the Calvin Wilkerson Award. And here I am now, receiving the Pinkett Wilkerson Award. I will do all I can to make sure that I hold this torch and move forward. Thank you.
I have the distinct honor to present the Charles I. Huston Award. The Charles I. Huston Visionary Award is awarded to those with the ability to envision a brighter, more positive future in their communities. And in honor of former Representative Charles Huston, a former dedicated Louisiana Legislative Black Caucus member, this year's recipient is a testament of the spirit of that work. It is none other than Dr. Rainey, the hip-hop Dr. Whitfield. Dr. Whitfield is a board-certified family physician with a certification of added qualification, CAQ, in sports medicine, and is currently in private practice in Baton Rouge. Dr. Whitfield is a heartfelt supporter for increasing the consciousness of health-related issues such as HIV and AIDS, obesity, cardiovascular disease, and substance abuse, which affects today's youth, our young adults, and the elderly. Dr. Whitfield is very involved in his local community and the surrounding areas. He has also come down to testify in our committees about the importance of health care and individuals having access to health care when we were trying to expand the Medicaid expansion. He has received numerous awards. He has an award from the American Academy of Family Physician Public Health Award, the NAACP Freedom Award, and now he will be a recipient of the Black Caucus Charles I. Huston Visionary Award. Please join me in welcoming to the podium, Dr. Whitfield.
I'm so glad I went to Southern U. All right, y'all, I'm fine. Listen, guys, seriously, for your state
to recognize you as someone that is giving back to the communities. It is one of the biggest blessings that I've ever received. When I got word that I was going to receive this award today, it literally brought tears to my eyes. I don't know if you guys understand that there are thousands of people in the state of Louisiana who are dying because of lack of access to quality, affordable health care. And when I look on this panel, Pat Smith, Karen Carter-Peterson, Mary, Cedric, Ted, I've seen them on the forefront fighting for our citizens. And when you got a governor like Bobby Jindal, then you need to use something to help people. And that's why I use hip-hop, because it's the only thing I can do, because Bobby ain't listening to none of us, y'all. So thank you so much for this honor today. And I hope that you guys will get out to the polls and vote. And as Cedric said earlier, it's not about Mary, it's about us. I really appreciate this award, you guys. Enjoy the game. Go Jags. Thank you so much.
My purpose here today is to present three awards, scholarship awards. We're pleased to present the inaugural Bayou Classic Jazz Brunch Scholarship, which was jointly created by the Office of the Louisiana Legislative Black Caucus Foundation and the Black Caucus Scholarship Jazz Brunch Committee. These scholarships will be awarded annually to three deserving students at the Bayou Classic Brunch, to recipients who exemplify scholastic achievement and academic excellence across the state. Our third place winner is Ms. Jakayla Lawson, a student at Dillard University. Ms. Lawson will receive a $500 scholarship to help with the cost of tuition and books during the spring 2015 semester. Our next scholarship recipient in second place is Mr. Jalen Lewis of Northwestern State University. He'll receive a scholarship of $750. And our first place winner is Ms. Jacqueline Addison of Southern University. Ms. Addison will receive a $1,000 scholarship.
The Eagle Award is presented to members who have decided to leave us, like Representative Jared Brossette, who is now Councilman Jared Brossette. Those are members who served their term in office and may not have served their entire term, but have decided to go on to greater pastures. And in that respect, I want to call up Representative Jared Brossette, who's now the city councilman for the city of New Orleans, and he's still fighting the good fight. And we want to congratulate him. Also want to call up our friend, our colleague, Representative Gerard Jackson, who elected not to sit up here with us. Who also served in South Louisiana and was very instrumental in disadvantaged business enterprise legislation and other economic development legislation while he was a member of the caucus. We're so happy to have them with us today. Thank you. Our platinum sponsors, giving at a $10,000 level for the second time in a row, no, third or fourth, let me be real, Carl Connor with BP continues to support the caucus and has for many years. We also have coming in at a $10,000 sponsorship level, which is very impressive because I don't think members of the caucus voted with this business during legislative session, but they understand that we're all working together to make a better Louisiana. They've become our friends because this gentleman speaks the truth, okay? Above all things, the first time I met with him, he had on a jazzy jacket, and he has on his velvet jacket today. Louisiana Payday Loan Association, represented also by Marquis Pierre, I believe. Thank you.
Why should businesses get involved in the foundation and supporting these scholarships?
Definitely. It touches statewide. With over 32 members across the state, businesses should really come on board to provide scholarships and help where needed in communities. When Hurricane Katrina hit, our foundation gave money for relief. And so we will come into special circumstances and give money for relief. Sometimes we'll have students to write us or young adults to write us who have an experience to represent Louisiana on a national level throughout organizations or scholar programs or even just honors, and we will help them get to where they're going. Most recently, we helped a young kid in Baton Rouge who was recognized nationally, was adopted, and excelled extremely past what his
past circumstances were. And so we do a lot. Businesses should be encouraged to get involved. It's a 501c3. It's a tax write-off, number one. And number two, it helps everyone across the state. We touch every city and every parish in the state.
I have had the opportunity to read some of the letters from some of the recipients who have received the scholarships. And if that amount of money goes a long way for some of the students in terms of being able to buy the necessities, such as supplies and books. And so the stipend that or the scholarships that our students receive is very much needed and really goes a long ways in helping them achieve their success and being able to finish school.
The Black Caucus Foundation actually is an arm of the Friends of the Black Caucus. They help us to raise money when we can't because we're a political arm and they are a nonprofit arm. So we're able to get them to raise money for us to be able to do things like this, to raise scholarship money for our students that we give to high school students, as well as helping us to put this on to raise money for any activities that we want. So we work hand in hand together as the foundation and the caucus. They can't help us with the political side, so we really are the ones who are in the trenches with that piece of it.
What kind of success have you seen from the students that have received the scholarships from the caucus?
The one that I can tell you about for sure is one that I gave to a young lady at my church. Actually, I gave about three to young ladies. They've all finished school, all are working. One is working on her master's, and she's doing it in a very unusual kind of way. She's doing surveys of students on health activities and things of that sort. They are so successful, and I guess that every caucus member who has actually given a scholarship to a young person and watched them graduate from high school, go on to college, really is a blessing, not only to them, but to us, because they're our future.
If it weren't for a scholarship, I couldn't have come to Tulane and played ball because we couldn't afford it. And a lot of young people are in the same situation. It's not whether they would or they could, but the student loans are so much. So the scholarships are just enough to give the energy and the impetus for folks to be able to go to school and give them a little hope.
Education, education, education. There's nothing more important. That's the future of this state. The future of this state isn't the price of oil. It's not the price of gasoline. It's not the unemployment rate. It's not how many banners or ribbons politicians can cut. It's education. And I wanted to come down to support this great program. I bought a table, scholarship for our bright young people to keep them in Louisiana, because I will tell you, we're losing them. And I'm so tired of seeing so many of our bright young people only twice a year, Thanksgiving and Christmas, when they come home to visit us from Denver and Dallas and Atlanta. We need to keep them in Louisiana.
If people have questions like more information, what should they do?
They can call 225-342-7342, or they can email us caucusb@legis.la.gov. And if you can't find anything else, just call the Louisiana State Capitol and ask for the Black Caucus, and you're going to get us.